हेलो, दिस इज द सीलिंग माउंट पीओपी माउंट मोशन सेंसर. दिस हैज़ द कैपेसिटी टू सेंस इन 360 डिग्री एंड विद अ रेंज ऑफ 7 मीटर्स टू 11 मीटर्स. एंड दिस इज द टाइम. सो यू कैन वेरी द टाइम फ्रॉम, इफ यू रिड्यूस इट टू द लेफ्ट साइड, इट वेरीज द टाइम फ्रॉम 3 सेकेंड्स द वेन एवर द सिग्नल इज received. 3 seconds the light will be on, automatically light goes off after 3 seconds. So if you can increase the time according to the requirement. And here is the input. There are two wires here, so live and neutral should come to this. So that means, so there is a bulb which gets live and neutral. So rather than going to the bulb, the input should directly come here to this point, and this will get triggered on. So after that there is a output here. So live and neutral comes from these two points. So this point has to go for output. You can see here output. So it has to go for output. So now I will do the connections and show you the working. So now I am taking a piece of wire. So I'll strip this wire. I'll cut it a bit. Take another piece of wire. So then from the input I will put this. I'll open the screws. I'll put this wire inside this. I'm using a very tiny load, that is a normal 20 watts bulb. So the gauge of the wire is enough for me. If any heavy load is required, the gauge of the wire should be increased according to the requirement. So my gauge, this much gauge is enough to power on up to 100 watts to 200 watts of bulbs. So now I will give this to the input. So I have made this for my use, for just for the testing purpose. I can give at any point, it does not matter. So live and neutral is given. So I'll be getting live and neutral here. So that live and neutral is coming here. So now I have to give the output from this point to this terminal. So I'll now connect the output. So I need a bigger wire. So now I'll connect it from the output terminals. So I'll first loose the screws. So then I'll put a wire in this, gently tight it up. So I'll make sure that it is not coming out. So I'll take another piece of wire. I'll put it inside. So it is not going inside, so I'll twist this up. So once it is done, pull it up, it's not coming out. So these two wires should go to the output. That's it. It's that simple. So there is nothing like you have to connect live and neutral to the bulb. A neutral should directly go to the bulb, live should be controlled by this. If you want, you can also use our device in that case also. If you just want to control the live, you can just give the live input and it will control only the live output. But to power on this device, you need to power input and output. Live and neutral should be given to this terminal to power on this device. So once this is on, you can control only live or you can control only neutral. You can also do that. So now once this is done, so let us test the circuit. So this is my power cord for this light. So I'll be giving the live and neutral to this point. So I'm not directly giving it to the bulb, I'm directly giving it to this input. So that input is coming, that means the live and neutral of this power cord comes to these terminals and this will power on this sensor circuit, and from sensor circuit I'm getting the output that is going to the bulb. So that is, it is connected in series. So I'll connect it so we can see that the light is on. So I have kept my timer in minimum. So you can change it according to your wish. So now after you switch it on the circuit, leave the sensor for approximately 1 minute so that it adjusts the room environment and room temperature. Once it gets settled down with the room environment and temperature, automatically it will start sensing. So now I will leave it for 1 minute and do a fast forward. So now my sensor is ready. So now I am giving a signal, it switches on automatically and switches off automatically. So this is just the 3 seconds time delay. So again I'll give a signal, so it is on, and after some few seconds it will switch off. Okay, so now there is a pot over here, you can use that to increase the time. So I'll increase the time for some particular time and I can see that my light is on for more amount of time. So this sensor has a provision to vary the time from 3 seconds to 7 minutes as per the requirement, can be varied. If required for more timer, a pre-order is required. This is the waiting time, we are waiting for the light to turn off. I am not giving any other signal. Yes, so it is approximately 1 minute time delay. So if the timer is increased to the max, it will go till 7 minutes. So I have now set it into 1 minute. So you can't set it exactly to 1 minute, you have to keep a stopwatch and then set it. So again it has taken my movement of my head and it has triggered on. And when there is no motion, so it will automatically, it does not turn on. So suppose now I'll reduce the time and turn it to the place where there is no motion. So yes, now it is off. So let us see whether it will switch on or switch off. So it is not taking any other signal, I guess. Yes, so it is not switching on. That means until and unless there is a motion, it won't turn on, because now I have turned my sensor to the opposite direction where there is no motion. So now I will just give a motion like this. So yes, it's turned on. So that's it. Thank you.